Welcome back to the Real Racing 3 walkthrough. We're in the middle of the Hypercar Charge series after winning the Koenigsegg Regera. And if you watched the video just prior to this one, you'll notice that I had a scratchy throat and was coughing and didn't notice at the end that our final tier is unlocked, which is the tier that has the cup race at Circuit to 24 hours, 3 laps. We're going to go ahead and hire Double Fame. I used a free one earlier. See how we do. I'm going to have to come back and talk off the friends, I guess. Dude, you don't want to get third place, second place, when you've got an agent hired. You had to get first place to get the double. First thing we do is get in first place. But the first thing that happens is they pull away from you. Then they start to brake for the turn, but we don't. And we go around them. Normally wouldn't have to recover this way. So we'll get to first place a little later than we planned, but long before we get to the long straight that's ahead. It's called the Mulsanne Straight. I'm not sure exactly why. It's spelled M-U-L-S-A-N-N-E. It's a long straight and the fastest part of this racetrack. The break point for this is in the middle of a little house's development on the left side. You start to see it now come up the left, right, in the middle of those here. 220 plus 36. Oh, it's too late. Maybe it should be the beginning of that housing section. I'll try that on the second lap. But anyway, the top speed was about 220, and if you add 30, that's about 250 some. 256. Well, pretty high top speed. I'm able to see that car coming up on the left. And you can see when it slowed back down, that was its breaking point. There are 3 places on this track that I like to slow down other cars. One of them is coming up. Not this turn, but the turn right after it. This one is called Indianapolis. This is, in my opinion, the only one I don't remember the name of. There is a name, but I call it the one after Indianapolis. And when they're beside you, it's not going to work. Too close. I should have got a bigger gap before I stopped. They already had their aim to go around. These turns, I think their S's are called, what's the name of that? It's a car name, I think Honda or some other car. There's a sign over the beginning of them. I missed it. Probably point it out on the second lap. Breaking point is right at the beginning of those buildings on the left. So tent canopy structures. This is the second place I like stopping. And since I've got a 221-yard lead, I can stop here. Can't really see it because I got this thing messed up. And he just went around. Oh, well. I'll have to show you better on the second try on this. Got a 4-minute lap here. 3 times 4 is 12 minutes total. I'll try to show the stopping point at the end of the Mulsanne Straight. It's my least favorite of the places. It's the first opportunity, but it's the least favorite of my places to stop the cars because there's a long straight coming right after it, and it makes it difficult to make up for any leaks through the stop point. If a car goes around or gets around after you've stopped them, it makes it difficult to catch up because of a long straight. But there, a lot of times the straights, they'll be faster than they are. Breaking really late. Here's a stopping point right at that barrier. Right about one wheel width away from the white line. So they all come and line up and kind of push, squeeze themselves through that little choke point. And then we start to get squirrely. Take off. This is when we get squirrely. One kind of goes in front of the other like that. And you may have to defend your position. Now, I think if they were fully serviced, we wouldn't have difficult a time staying ahead of these cars. But since we are not fully serviced, we have to catch up to them on the chicanes and pass them. They slow much earlier than need be. They don't accelerate as early as they can. And so we take advantage and head off into the sunset. Now, Vincent V is a little close, so we may have to defend against him passing in this long straight. This is the second longest or second fastest, maybe, I don't know the distance, but second fastest part on the track. Breakpoint for this is the sand on the right side there. That may be a little early. I'll build up a little bit of lead so we can stop Vincent at this point. Get up here and stop right on this corner with your wheels on the ripple strip. And the cars will come right behind you and stop. Or slow. Now you see your time when you take off here. That'll be the time that you have when you end the race. Plus a minute. So we'll probably end this minute lap time 4:15. If things don't go crazy. But this one I like better because right after this little straight section is the turns that allow you to go back around past them. They slow down and we don't. Well, I shouldn't say we don't slow down. We don't slow down as much. Come on, get on track. And this point here, as I tried to demonstrate last time, is a good place for stopping right on the ripple strip. If you center yourself over the center of the strip in the turn, if they bend there, it should be a good point for them to stop. Now, we're at 4:25, but I'm stopping here, so we were at 3:15 at the last turn where we stopped them. And it would have been 4:15 if we hadn't stopped the cars. This is a corner you can stop into. But... it's a little bit of a wider path there. Some more cars will end up going around. You can't stop them for as long. The turn ahead, the one going right, is the one you really want to learn how to do well, because it's the one that's going to slingshot you fastest down this track. You get your speed records and get ahead of the cars. Well, you may not get ahead of cars, but you can pull away from cars. See, I'm still pulling away from turn a page. Oh, now he's starting to catch back up. All right, we'll try this breakpoint, beginning of the buildings now, 218. At 36, now I'm way too early. That's interesting. Maybe it didn't register for me. Oh, well. You run it, you'll earn it. We are on the final lap, so we'll do less spot slowing. I'm braking late, so I'm going to have to skid and stop. Skid and slow down. Instead of running into a barrier, I think it's preferable. And so we have a quick 15-minute. Looks like you're really late. Quick little 15-minute farm run that gives us some good fame payout, especially if you double it. And if you double it on a double fame day, you get 4 times 7,700 fame points. That's a pretty good little payout. It might be half of a driver level, depending on what your level is. Actually go through probably 130 with the grip we have, and 120 on the curves ahead. We'll stay right here and then cut back to the left, because this one's kind of sharp. And it'll push you off into that off track there. It really is slow. Yeah, so we'll have to stop here and get a close finish. There we go, finish off the race nicely and collect our fame and fortune. There's the fortune, $32,000 racing dollars. And here's the fame, $15,400. That could be $30,000 on double fame days. So there we go. Yeah, it's a good fame-paying race. Thank you for watching. And this is a totally unserviced, so you can just run this over and over. No servicing. Thank you for watching my videos. Good luck to you and your challenges in Real Racing 3. And come back and see where we go next.